our emotions and health through Vedic science of Ras Yoga. Preeti is the founder, director and creative force behind Om Ved, a retail chain of stores of pure and natural products based on the Vedic science. She was introduced to yoga and naturopathy when she was just 3 by her mother and grandmother who used to experiment with herbs, seeds and flowers. The lessons she learned as a child were applied to her life when she became a mother. That time she was a successful jewelry designer. This is when she started researching and analyzing for natural botanicals. While researching, she came back to the ancient Vedic traditions and she discovered all the answers on living a pure natural lifestyle. That was the birth of Om Ved. Preeti has developed Om Ved line of products with renowned Ayurvedic practitioners and experts of yoga, vastu, jyotish, ras tantra and bhakti ved. Her products are completely natural, organic, non-toxic, which can help us to achieve healthier and holistic living. Friends, may I now call upon Preeti to please share her experience.
I'm indeed very honored to be here. My first Rotary speech was 20 years ago at the Rotary Metropolitan. My father's a Rotarian. And that was at that time on jewelry. So this is quite a change from where I've been. I come from a company, Om Ved, and she said a lot of good things already. And I don't want to talk about products or services or anything. What I'm here to talk about today is how we feel and how that affects our health as described by an ancient science called Rasa Tantra. Om Ved is here to help people find their pure self. This is what we mean by pure natural living, where we help people find their pure self, their natural potential, and equip people to live life to the fullest, to live life a very holistic and balanced way, to live it in consciousness, to be aware of the choices we make. At Om Ved, we believe that health and wellness is essential, and for that, it is important to be in balance. And balance can be achieved if you're balanced in 6 areas of your life. And this is what was described by the Vedic traditions. So physical vitality, they suggested Ayurveda. For mental clarity, they suggested yoga. And today we're going to talk about a very simple topic, it's emotional bliss. Very often we are so preoccupied with the physical and the mental because these are all being classified as disorders and people know the medications and things like that. But a very important part is the emotional wellness, the emotional balance. And I don't promise you to be master of your emotions in 20 minutes because I've been trying for the last 3 years and I'm nowhere close to that. But what I do promise is to share with you secrets from Rasa Tantra, which is an extremely old ancient Vedic science. It helps you lower the negative emotions and accentuate the positive ones. Rasa in Sanskrit means essence or juice. It's the basic vitality of life. And health has been defined by Ayurveda or by the Vedic traditions. And now WHO also adopts the same thing. It's not just the absence of disease. Just because you don't have a disease does not mean that you're healthy. But it's a constant feeling of bliss, constant feeling of joy, constant feeling of energy. And it's the same thing for emotional health. Just because you don't have a mental trauma or a psychological disorder or depression does not mean that you are joy, that you're happy, that you're positive in mental health. Because not feeling bad is not the same thing as not feeling good or feeling good. All of the pursuits that we do, everything that we feel, all the actions that we take is with one aim, and that is for happiness. So if we're buying a car, it's not because of the tires and this steel contraption. It's the feeling that we will get when we buy the car. And this happiness, Vedic tradition says, there's a very simple way to be happy. stop being unhappy. But it's easier said than done. And Rasa Sadhana will explain how this is possible. The word Rasa was first mentioned in the Rig Vedas, and then it was later described in detail in Natya Shastra, which is basically also called the fifth Veda because it was so important. And this was explained in the Natya Shastra by Bharat Muni, where he said that there are 9 basic emotions. And that can be aroused in somebody who is watching a painting, who is watching a dance, who is listening to music, depending on the bhav or the gestures that they make. And this is very interesting because, okay, I'll come to that. There are basically 9 emotions, and there are 4 agreeable or the positive emotions like we see it, 4 the not so agreeable, the negative, and 1 which is basically a place of mind where there is really less emotion or no emotion, which is calm. So you have love, wonder, laughter, courage, which are the positive ones, and then you have anger, fear, sadness, and disgust. And when there's pure shanta, when there's pure calmness, then it's samadhi. So that's the state that we all strive for. And which is surprising, because this happened 2,500 years ago. It actually happened much earlier, but it was recorded 2,500 years ago. And it was only as late as the 20th century when we had an actually elaborate study done of 21 cultures by Paul Ekman, where he also came to the conclusion that there are 6 emotions that are identified by people all over the world, irrespective of where they come from, what age they are, male, female. It's universally the same emotions. And 6 of the emotions out of the 9 are common. The 3 that didn't make it in this list was love, calmness, and courage. But that's also because it's not really a facial expression. Now, there are too many doctors here, so I'm not going to talk too much in detail about this. But how this affects, how our emotions basically affect us is through neurotransmitters and neurons. So when you feel something, in very simple words, there is a highway that is built between, and neurotransmitters are used, like adrenaline or serotonin or dopamine, to transfer this emotion to another neuron. The more you use that emotion, the thicker or bigger the road becomes. And regular repeated use, it becomes an emotional highway. So the next time you get an impulse, supposing you've used the anger emotion very a lot, anything will make you angry because that's the reaction that your body knows. So it's very similar to walking on a path which has tall grass. If you walk one time, the grass goes back, it gets straight, and you don't really know where you came or where you went. If you walk more often, then there's a little road that is built. But if you walk repeatedly, then there's a highway with no grass, and it becomes very easy for you to go from one point to the other, which is very similar to the way we feel an emotion. So for example, as a child, if you were exposed to the beach, and every time you went to the beach, you felt really happy. So that's the emotion that gets triggered every time you see a beach, even as an adult, because your brain has made that connection. So similarly, if you had a bad reaction every time that you were holding a matchstick and your parent was yelling at you or was upset with you, then even as an adult, when you see that matchstick, you will have the same fear, because that was a reaction that your brain learned to that stimulus. And that's essentially what it is. Your emotions are just reactions to a stimulus. But it's also a little bit more than that. To understand these Navarasas, I'm just going to quickly go through each of the rasas so that you understand a little bit more detail how it affects our life. Love is basically the king of all rasas. You know, all your problems can be solved. When you're in love, you feel happy. And love is also, Shringara Rasa is also love and beauty. And which makes sense, because if you love something, you find it beautiful. Or if you love somebody, you find that person beautiful. And vice versa, if you find something beautiful, it's most natural that you're going to love that thing. So love and beauty go together. To master love, it's very important to learn how to be detached. So Because if you're very attached to the object of your love or the person that you love, and when that person disappears, then you're going to be into sadness and depression and all of that. So the Rasa Tantra says that when you, even though love is a positive emotion, it can topple the balance if you're not careful. In aromatherapy, we also believe that it bypasses your thinking brain, which is different from when you see something. If you see something, your brain is actually the one that is registering the images. But when you smell something, it bypasses your thinking and you suddenly feel better. It changes your mood. So aromatherapy is very important to use in balancing your emotions. And the emotion, jasmine, is often used for love. So you always see in weddings and things like that, people have jasmine in their hair. And there was a reason for that, because it enhanced the love emotion. All the 16 shringar came from the shringar rasa. Laughter is an antidote for everything. It solves all our problems, because it makes you suddenly realize that it's a temporary problem. It makes you realize the illusionary or the elusive nature of your problem. So laughter, humor, satire, telling jokes, sharing jokes. And the good thing about laughter is that it's also contagious. So when you share a joke, you also feel happy yourself. Wanda rasa, or the rasa of awe, amazement. You know, when you look at a flower, when you look at the sky full of stars, that's the rasa of Adbhuta. Where you feel awe, you feel small, you feel humble. And this is a rasa which is very often overlooked by people. It's not given really the importance. But to live a life with gratitude, to live a life that of humility, really takes you away from most of the problem rasas or the most of the illnesses that you would have. Courage rasa, I think every day everybody is a hero most of the time because of all the challenges that we face. In the olden days, it was the fear. You had to be brave to defend yourself. Now it's not like that. We're not at war. I hope not. But it's important to understand that when you're very strong and when you're very brave, if you don't balance yourself, you can get the feeling of pride. So again, this rasa is something that we need to put in balance. Fear is one of the not so agreeable rasas. And fear also leads to worry and nervousness. Most often the fear is because your mind is oscillating between the past and the future. So you're regretting the things that you did or the mistakes that you made. And you're also anxious about the future because you don't know it. You can't control it. Sadness, I think all of us are familiar with that one. But sadness in Rasa Tantra goes from feeling bad for yourself to compassion. And a lot of people don't understand why this is put together. But it's because it's very easy to feel bad for yourself. It's very easy to feel depressed. It's very easy to feel down. But if we are able to move from this personal sadness and turn it into compassion for somebody else, for something else, then that helps us from not getting very sad. And of course, it's always better to go the opposite rasa, which is laughter. Anger rasa, I think that's getting on the rise every day because we get irritated with everything, we're angry with everything. But the root cause of anger, there's only one cause, and which is expectation. Because I expected something to happen and it didn't happen, then I'm angry. Because I expected somebody to listen to me and they didn't listen to me, then I'm angry. So the easiest way to control anger would be to understand what was it that I was expecting? What was it that I expected to happen? And why should that happen the way I expected it to happen? Disgust is the last rasa, where it's the state where we call depression now, where there is dissatisfaction with yourself and dissatisfaction with the world. So it's beyond the sadness. Sadness, you're only dissatisfied with yourself. And this is a place of no hope. So this is really something where Rasa Tantra says that it just should not exist. It's not about balancing it. It just should not exist. So before, if we are able to balance the other emotions, then you won't get to the stage of disgust or depression, because it's a complex blend of too many emotions. And of course, what we all strive for is calmness or shanta. Now, the way that Rasa Tantra says for you to be in this calm state, or you should look for this calm state, even if you're angry, you first come to this state of calmness before you choose which other positive emotion you want to get into your life. Meditation, relaxation, breathing. And it also says pay your debts. And there are all kinds of debts. It's not only financial debt. It's also debt to your ancestors, through your children, debt to your teachers, debt to your community. I think we all do it well as Rotarians. It also talks about reducing your needs. Because the more needs you have, the more you struggle for those needs, the more you struggle to achieve those needs. So it's better, the feeling of contentment helps when you're dealing with Shanta Rasa. Now there are six steps to work with your rasas. The first one is to stop identifying with the rasa. So if you're angry, then anger, you have to understand that it's a stimulus. And you choose how you're going to react to that anger. You can relearn whatever you've learned. So if you always choose to get angry, maybe one day you can try to choose a different reaction. But anger is not you, it's just outside. Immediately change your body chemistry. So for example, if you're angry, drink a few glasses of water, because anger is fire and water will cool it down. Or if you're sad, I mean, if you feel like crying, that's fine. Maybe you can wash your eyes with rose water or water afterwards to calm yourself down. Maybe you can chew cardamom. If you're depressed or if you're in the feeling of disgust, again, light juices, fruits. So there are lots of ways to change that body chemistry to keep it ready so that not to affect your body. Induce calmness. Again, this is very important, especially with all our illnesses now, all the ailments that we have now. A simple 3-minute break